Hello guys, welcome back to the Political Science Forum. In this video, we are going to learn Gandhiji's views on state. State has been an important concern of the political science. The institution of state has been analyzed by the political scholars and philosophers right from the ancient times to the modern times. In the ancient times, it was Plato who said that the state should be ruled by the philosopher king. What should be the characteristics of an ideal state, how justice can be secured in the ideal state, and so on. The state has been analyzed right from the ancient times, and in the modern times we have thinkers like Karl Marx who says that the state is an instrument in the hands of the capitalists to subordinate and suppress and oppress the workers. So this is how the institution of the state has been analyzed by various philosophers from their own perspectives. And these scholars and philosophers have put up their own understanding of the institution of the state, and they have come up with their own understanding about the features of the state, about the characteristics of the state, and so on. So we can say that the state is essentially a contested concept, and different authors and different philosophers put up their own understanding of the state. Before we begin to study the Gandhiji's views on the state, we have to remember that Gandhiji's views on the state, or in general Mahatma Gandhi's philosophy, has been influenced by three major factors. These are the influence of Hinduism, especially the Bhagavad Gita, on Mahatma Gandhi, Gandhiji's experience under the colonial state, under the British rule, and the third one is the spiritual inclinations of Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi offers a very credible critique of the institution of the state. According to Mahatma Gandhi, the state is a manifestation of the hard power. The state has its own apparatus of hard power, which comprises the police, bureaucracy, army, and so on. And therefore, the institution of the state is a sort of a hindrance on the spiritual development and the spiritual liberty of an individual. According to Mahatma Gandhi, the state is a soulless machine. So I specifically highlighted the word soulless machine because these are the terms that you should use while writing the answers on this topic. After offering the critique of the mainstream view of the state, now Mahatma Gandhi puts up his own understanding of the institution of the state. According to Mahatma Gandhi, Ram Rajya is the ideal state. In Ram Rajya, there would be complete justice. All the people would be treated as ends in themselves, and no one would be treated as means to some distant ends outside themselves. In this Ram Rajya, there would be ahimsa, or the state of Ram Rajya would be based on the philosophy of ahimsa. The Ram Rajya would ensure spiritual liberty and spiritual development and spiritual advancement of the individual. The Ram Rajya is based on justice. The Ram Rajya is a very inclusive and a very progressive idea and a very progressive notion that Mahatma Gandhi has given. So the idea of Ram Rajya as given by Mahatma Gandhi is a very progressive idea, and it has to be analyzed in a very liberal manner. Mahatma Gandhi also talks about what is called as the enlightened anarchy. According to Mahatma Gandhi, when all the people are self-disciplined and self-regulated, the institution of state would no more be required. In this state of enlightened anarchy, the state would become redundant and then it would wither away eventually. So in a sense, we can say that Mahatma Gandhi is an anarchist, but a pacifist anarchist. His views on the state are very close to the views of the anarchist. However, Mahatma Gandhi, though he comes closer to Karl Marx when he says that there should be a stateless society, but he differs with Karl Marx on one point. According to Mahatma Gandhi, the institution of state is not to be uprooted by a violent revolution, as has been said by Karl Marx. In the opinion of Mahatma Gandhi, the state would eventually become redundant and it will eventually wither away once we achieve the state of enlightened anarchy. The question on Gandhiji's view on state has been asked in the previous year question paper of the UPSC mains. You can expect a 10 marker or a 15 marker on this point. You can also make use of the Gandhiji's view on state in some other question that has been asked on the state. You can also make use of Gandhiji's view on state on some other topic like the theories of the state. in which we study the liberal, neoliberal, Marxist and post-colonial views on state. You can also make use of Gandhiji's view on state on the topic of justice. We can say that in the state of Ramrajya, there would be complete justice, there would be purity of means and purity of ends. So this is how you can make use of this content in writing and making your answers comprehensive. If you have any doubts or queries, do mention them in the comment section below. I'd love to answer your doubts and queries. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Thank you so much.